Good morning. It is filled to the brim, and it is Monday, August 3rd. And the Holy Spirit is speaking, and it's real simple, actually. He says, I will help you. I will help you. You know, one of the names of God is the Helper of Israel. The Helper of Israel. And actually, in Genesis chapter 2, when the Lord made Eve for Adam, he called her a helper. And then the term or the word in Hebrew, Ezer, is the same word that is used for God as helper. So even in Genesis 2, when that term is used, it doesn't mean somebody that's subordinate, but rather an equal that helps bring about the mission that is on the people. It brings about the victory, fulfilling the mission, because the helper has strength. What's intrinsic to the word Ezer is the helper has strength. So I want to really emphasize that the Holy Spirit is saying, I will help you. I want to help you. Let me help you. Many times we go about our battles, the things that we have to do, our responsibilities, and we have so much stress trying to handle it all, trying to manage it all, when the Lord is present to be our helper. That's one reason why Jesus says, take my yoke upon you, for my yoke is easy, my burden is light. That he helps us in the journey, and we need to embrace our helper. The Holy Spirit is our helper. So this is what the Lord wants us to know. And in Isaiah 41:10, I'm going to focus in on Isaiah 41. It speaks to Israel, and Israel is in captivity. And the Lord is telling Israel that he is going to be Israel's helper in this time of difficulty. Here it says, Isaiah 41:10, do not fear anything, for I am with you. Do not be afraid, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Be assured, I will help you. I will help you. I will certainly take hold of you with my righteous right hand, a hand of justice, power, victory, and salvation. When the Lord helps us, he takes hold of us, and he brings about in our lives justice, power, victory, salvation. Do you need any of those things in your life, in your situation? Do you need justice? Do you need his power? Do you need victory? Do you need him to save you from something, deliver you out of something, out of a mess, out of a financial mess, out of a difficulty, out of a problem, out of something that you cannot resolve yourself? Well, the Lord says, I want to do that. I am your helper. Now, in Isaiah 41:11, this is the result of him helping us. All angry with you will be humiliated. That's verse 11 of Isaiah 41. Those who are angry with you, if you are in righteous relationship with the Lord, the angry people that are against you will be humiliated. Those who strive against you will be as nothing. Have you ever felt like you've been unloaded upon with people who are just coming against you and you're trying to do the right thing? Well, when the Lord is your helper, when you embrace the Lord, not doing it in your own strength, not trying to do it in your own self-righteousness, in your own flesh, but rather saying, Lord, you are my helper. You are my strength. Take hold of my hand, Lord. He says, those who strive against you will be as nothing. Verse 12, you shall search for those who quarrel with you, but you will not find them. How do you like that? I love that. Those who are trying to quarrel with me, I'm going to look for them and they're gone. Verse 12, those who war against you will be as nothing. Verse 13, for I, the Lord your God, keep hold of your right hand, who says to you, do not fear, I will help you. Are you struggling with fear? Some of us have foreboding, a foreboding spirit, meaning we're wondering, what's the next shoe to drop on me? What's the next bad thing to happen to me? And the Lord is saying, I will help you. Do not fear. Do not fear that something else bad is going to happen. I will help you. Verse 14 says, do not fear, you worm Jacob, you men of Israel. I will help you. Why does the Lord say, you worm Jacob? You know, the fact is this. When we recognize that we need the Lord's help, we see the smallness of ourselves. We see the disparity between God's ability and our ability, knowing that His ability is limitless and my ability is limited. That's why we need Ezer. We need Jehovah Ezer, the God who helps us, and He helps us with strength. He is our helper. And the fact is this, when He helps us, He empowers us, because the scripture goes on to say in Isaiah 41:15, in fact, I have made of you a new sharp threshing implement with sharp edges. You will thresh the mountains and crush them and make the hills like chaff. You will rejoice in the Lord. You will glory in the Holy One of Israel. See, the fact is that this is when we embrace our helper, that we actually are empowered, because we have embraced our helper and He makes us into a new sharp threshing implement to take down these obstacles, to take down the mountains and the hills that are in our way of victory, of deliverance, of salvation, of provision, because we have allowed, we have submitted ourselves, we have surrendered ourselves to the helper. He is our helper. You know, Jesus spoke of the Holy Spirit as our helper in John 14:16-17. I will ask the Father, and He will give you another helper, that He may be with you forever. And that is the Spirit of truth. The Holy Spirit is our helper. Surrender to the Holy Spirit today. Let go. Some of us get so like tightly fisted, trying to make it happen, trying to do it in our own strength, not even realizing that we have shifted back into our own strength. And the Lord is saying, let me help you. I want to help you. I want to help you. He has the answers for you. He has the strength for you. He is there to help you. His greatest desire is to help you today. Pray about this word. I love you. God bless you.